distinguished academics, members of the Governing Council of the International League for Human Rights, leaders of the Taiwanese community, and the hundreds of honored guests who have literally traveled by subway, car, train, and plane to be with us this evening to honor and pay tribute to one of the most remarkable defenders of human rights of our time. And more than this, it is the most successful award dinner in the league's history. Born during the darkest hours of World War II, the International League for Human Rights is the oldest international human rights organization in the United States. Years, the League has been unique in its steadfast commitment to defend and work side by side with the defenders of human rights in their homelands. Today, the International League for Human Rights works with scores of individuals and grassroots human rights organizations through our network of affiliates and partners in every region of the world on important issues ranging from civil and political rights, freedom of the press, self-determination, and the rights of women and children. At no time has our work been more critical and important as it is today. Cherished human rights are being threatened in every corner of the world. It is therefore altogether fitting that we gather here tonight to honor and pay tribute to one of the great defenders of human rights, because it is these individuals who are the true heroes of our contemporary society.
Thank you, Luis. President Chen, Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, 2003 has been a difficult year for the human rights movement. In general, we have seen retrenchment and the state of human rights around the world. Governments in many nations have made opportunistic use of the war against terror, indiscriminately labeling their opponents as terrorists and cutting back on the core freedoms which are enshrined in the Universal Declaration. Religious intolerance has grown. The ancient crime of human trafficking, opposition to which gave birth to the modern human rights movement in the 19th century, has made a shocking resurgence. These setbacks cause the human rights movement grave concern, but they also tempt us to look carefully for governments which are getting it right, which are providing a positive, responsible model to the international community. East Asia, it is often said, stands outside the supposedly Western human rights paradigm. Asian leaders from Beijing to Singapore and Kuala Lumpur have loudly proclaimed Asian values and asserted that the human rights values of the Universal Declaration are not universal. They are wrong. Indeed, where hundreds of thousands of citizens took to the streets to protest the attempt to import elements of Beijing-style authoritarianism through the enactment of Article 23, the State Security Law. This unexpected mass action reflected more than concern about a troubling but technical statute. It showed a craving for democracy and human rights and a rejection of cronyism and authoritarian rule. The people spoke. Even by the arrogant octogenarians who rule from Beijing. Yeah. We look Notwithstanding a menacing security environment and a troubled economy, Korean voters went to the polls, and for a second consecutive presidential election, they picked a champion of the cause of human rights as their president. Polling in Korea showed that people were troubled by their economy, and they were uncertain of many of the answers that were offered by political candidates. But in the end, nothing mattered more to them than the assurance that the reborn democracy of Korea would be preserved and a return to the autocratic practices of the past would be avoided. And finally, we come to the point of our festivities this evening, the Republic of China on Taiwan. When dealing with human rights advocates in Hong Kong earlier this year, I was repeatedly impressed when they expressed their joy, indeed their pride, and the fact that the Chinese-speaking world was no longer an exclusive club of autocrats and dictators. Now, the Chinese-speaking community has a genuine, vibrant democracy, a state built on respect for human rights and the values of a civil society. And that state, ladies and gentlemen, is the Republic of China on Taiwan. In extending the International Human Rights Award of 2003 to President Chen Shui-bian, the International League recognizes an individual, a human rights campaigner, and his accomplishments. But we also recognize the remarkable transformation of the state on Taiwan after decades of crippling authoritarianism to be one of the world's genuine democracies and a state which shows true adherence to the values of the Universal Declaration. This, however, is not the sole accomplishment of Chen Shui-bian. Much credit goes to the people on Taiwan. And we would be remiss this evening without extending our congratulations to them for their valiant and successful struggle. People of Taiwan, we salute you. We salute your accomplishments. You provide a model for the Chinese-speaking community, for Asia, and for the world.